Hello and welcome to Canvas Verde Conference 21. Hi, hello and welcome to Canvas Verde Conference 21. So let me introduce you to the synopsis of the conference. So today we're going to talk about the design, hardware, software, future, and where it's headed. Let us start with the intro. Canvas One Colors. She's a rainbow. Yeah, young fledgling company of the West Coast invents Canvas One, and it was for digital photography and artwork. So it gradually started as a startup, and we moved to Canvas Two series of dreams, and it was for industry on several different fields, and it was so popular. And it was 2017, and 2017 and 18, Puck Nano, it became even more popular, and it's sun transfective and sunlight readable. Canvas 2, obviously, it was inspired by Dylan, Bob Dylan's Seeds of Dreams, and Canvas 4 generation, Colors of Boxes, Let's Show Them We Are Better by Chainsmokers. So we are inspired by amazing bands and artists. Let us delve into Canvas Forge. Fourth generation cellular network and OS for Mount Kilimanjaro, Colors of Boxes, and it had a 13-inch touch series, and it was tremendous. And then came Solar Wireless Paradox. Canvas 4D conference. We were working on technology years behind for Mars Touch, but even Solar Wireless Paradox was the same. We were working years behind both of these products, dock and the actual touch computer. So Solar Wireless Paradox, the first of a conference, was a introduction of significant proportion, and Mars Touch 5G is a revolutionizing launch. It's going to revolutionize a lot of fields and a lot of industries, and it's a revolutionary launch. And Solar Wireless Paradox 2020 was pretty cool, and future is going to go robotic, and a lot of competitors and big companies have entered the market, and it's interesting, and the competition is on. And now we are, it's 2021, so we have launched Mars Touch 5G, and you've seen some pictures of Mars Touch 5G. Now I'm gonna show you it in demo. And desktop and tablet and smartphone, it's great. I mean, smartphones and tablets were tremendous advancement in technology, but big companies and the big brothers have been just, you know, stranded. They are just stranded with desktop and laptops and tablets. Who's gonna change? You know, who's gonna? Is it a fledgling startup? Who's gonna change? So we have been changing constantly. We've been introducing amazing revolutionary products, and I mean, we're not against competition. We're just against people not having, you know, not having original ideas. That's it. You know, competition is good for the country and the world. But you know what? Innovation is essential, and we are doing that. So, you know, we welcome your big companies. We welcome you, but we welcome competition, but don't be blatantly unimaginative and not think of original ideas. Try to compete in a decent way. And now, MassTouch 5G, it's infinitely intertwined. It's insanely cool. Infinitely cool. I mean, it's infinitely intertwined. So now, it's touch computers. And it's completely touch. Touch computers means there's no keyboard, no mouse, no peripherals. There's no stylus. Who wanna carry all of this? You know, so nope, nothing.
And it's breathtaking. It's made of aluminum material.
Hi, now let's look at the design. So it's aluminum white painted. And it has biometric access. And a speck of white so fair and pale. And it's amazing. And so here's pop-up cam. It's a cute little pop-up cam. And you can see that we have facilities for eSIM and nano SIMs and SD cards and MSD cards and micro SD cards, and also for wireless power dock, wireless charging, the latch is gonna enter, and also you know, you can also insert, you know, like you can connect it with a lot of other accessories and stuff, and also an opening for pop-up cam. And that's upslide, and upslide using biometric access to receive hardware goodies, turtle and drone cam.
So yeah, 10 inch touch, and it has 64 million colors, and it's sunlight readable. So I had e-meetings with a lot of people from different factories and would love to visit just-in-time factories on new methodologies like clean.
And magnetic attach and detach, so you can use the product and you can just place it back and it'll all automatically magnetically. And this is tremendous, inspired by the usual fans. So drone cam is basically, you know, we're just tired of selfie sticks, selfie cameras, front camera, back camera. Oh my god, we're so tired of it. Let us now, you know, let us introduce drone cam, but circulated only in a Wi-Fi region because we don't, you know, of privacy concerns. So let's just put Wi-Fi and Bluetooth on board, you know, and you know, and place a camera, a 4K camera to record videos and images, and it'll be transferred directly to your devices via Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. And the interesting fun fact is that it's ephemeral, so it has an inbuilt flash storage, and it automatically transfers it to your devices, syncs via wireless, and it doesn't use, you know, it doesn't store for a longer period of time, so you don't have to worry about it. So now for the more interesting part. So we have been in touch with Qualcomm and their affiliates and partners for more than 2 years now, and just tremendous people, and we love their fifth generation and fourth generation chip and the old chip technology, because we love it on our device, and we would love to continue the partnership in the future. So because they have a powerful AI 5G chip with inbuilt antennas and biometric access and all kinds of, you know, Cairo processor, sensing hub, so many things bundled together, you know, a lot of stuff for an interesting future. So we love the relationship, and we would love to continue into the future. We love additive manufacturing and lights of manufacturing. It's exciting and tremendous future, because we spoke to a lot of smart people working on it, and man, we love it, because it's just tremendous, you know, it's exciting technology and into the future. And also there is a huge need for us, a huge need, because we are designing a system and package, and they have the right solution. We have an integrated board, and they have the right solution. So it's gonna be a mix of both additive and 3D and you know, and the regular stuff. So it's gonna be a mix and match. And since we have a large board, an integrated board with a lot of components, you know, so I think we'll have an amazing relationship with all the players. And we love additive because it's eco-friendly and all that stuff. But let us, you know, if we just wanna, you know, do it. We wanna, you know, we wanna create products. We're just gonna build products, and hopefully, you know, do a factory visit and produce stuff. And because it's an exciting future. And so Gyroscope and Accelerometer and Tortle, Harris Tortle, in short, Tortle. So it'll have, you know, it's just gonna reply you in huge details of text. Just kidding. I'm sorry. Just numbers. Just number. You know, no text, nothing, no voice, just number. You're gonna ask a question, or you're gonna take it out for your fitness work or whatever, sports, cycling, or climbing up the mountain, or whatever you wanna do. You know, like if you're curious and you wanna know an answer to a question, it's gonna reply only in numbers. So it's a very cute device, and it'll be very, very useful. So, you know, like when you don't have time, you're just gonna need to know, like, the time, or timer, or stopwatch, or lapse, or the date, or calendar. It's like, you know, you can just ask it, and it'll just project results and numbers. That's it. So, you know, and future, we're gonna increase number of sensors, and you can use it for a lot of sports and all other stuff, and fitness tracking, so many things. But we're just gonna, for now, we're just gonna try to be as smart as possible. Smart as possible, because it's named after Aristotle. and magnetic attachment to that. So you can use the product and you can just place it back and it will all automatically, magnetically.
Curiosity rolling is the only sound when we leave here. When we leave here, pile them up, jump up, fall down, make a crunching sound, jump up, fall down. Pile them up, jump up, fall down, make a crunch.
So we're gonna have system-wide hardware and software AI because of hardware-enabled AI processors and special separate processors. We're gonna have amazing softwares in future, and it's gonna have system-wide. You know, you don't have to. It can organize files for you and so many things. You know, say it can. You know, provide you search all over the internet and provide answers from Wikipedia, Wolf from Alpha, or so many stuff, and that's where we're headed to, and it's pretty exciting. And I mean, it's just limited what I'm talking, but AI's future is far-reaching, and AI coupled with fifth generation and smart city scenario, it's, you know, where there is eco cars and electric vehicles and power grids and mission critical applications. It's tremendous what we can do with it.